Hey, so I want to talk a little about having a process orientation. And I mean a process orientation specifically with regard to yoga, meditation, ecstatic dance, what we do at Dance Tribe, bodywork. So really any mind-body discipline. If we have a process orientation, I think it makes all the difference. I think having a process orientation is perhaps the single determining factor as to whether the practice is going to be grounded, integrated, truly beneficial, authentic, something that you can, a rich well that you can keep coming back to that's really going to serve you in your life. So what do I mean by a process orientation? The way that I'm defining it, a process orientation is essentially the attitude that the process matters, that what shows up for you while you're engaged in the practice is not in the way, it actually is the way, that the process is valuable, and that out of that process emerges insight, healing, new possibilities, learning, growth, any of the good things that we hope to gain from mind-body practice comes out of the process. So the process is not in the way. Your sensations, your emotions, your thought patterns, whatever might come up, the fears, the distractions, the judgments, all of that is grist for the mill. The material that shows up in your awareness while you're engaged in an awareness practice is important. It really matters. Now, that may seem obvious if you've only ever engaged in practices the way I or some of the people that, you know, I really resonate with teach them, but it's not the only approach, right? Another approach might be perhaps a more transcendentalist approach, which starts from a preconceived notion of what is supposed to happen. So for example, while you're meditating, maybe you have this idea that you're supposed to only be present. And so any thoughts that you have about the past or the future, oh, you messed up, you're not really in the present anymore, you're not doing the meditation right, your thoughts are in the way. Process orientation would say, oh, isn't that interesting? Look at the thoughts, look at what I'm preoccupied with. Look at how much emotional meaning I'm putting on that conversation that happened yesterday, or on my anxiety about the thing that's going to happen tomorrow. If I pay closer attention to that, I wonder if I can get underneath it and have some compassion for the part of me that carries that anxiety or that insecurity. If I pay closer attention to it, I wonder if I can learn about the particular ways in which I seek to gain control over things that I actually don't have control over. And that way I become a little more free, a little more compassionate, and I gain insight into my inner workings, which is what a mind-body practice should do, right? So if you start from the place I certainly started here, and maybe you have as well, with meditation, where you say, well, your thoughts are in the way and you're just trying to get rid of them, or you're only supposed to be in the present, and so if you're thinking about past and future, that's an illusion, and you're not going to be enlightened, right? Then what you end up doing is pushing aside the process, which contains the ingredients of the transformational power of the practice, if you're able to then relate to your experience with more compassion, more honesty, more courage, and thereby gain insight and healing and integration and growth.